Andrew McCart, IFL TV, association with MTK Global. I'm here with Sean. Sean McCormann, what a performance, mate. I mean, after your last performance being dropped and all that going the distance, was this the performance you needed, mate?
Yeah, no, it is. People always seen this, the skill I had. Especially people coming in around the gym with Danny, and I've always heard Danny saying it, and people saying the skill I have, people who see me behind closed doors training and sparring and stuff. And the night wasn't a skillful performance. It was just, there was maybe three key factors that I had to go out and do the night, part of game plan, and I've done exactly that. So it just lets you know that I can adjust. My skill is adjustable, and I'm able to adjust to the fit, especially on a big platform, main event for the first time, and against a really dangerous operator, and Maximiliano Godoy with 17 knockouts and 32 wins. So,
sweet. Danny told me a very interesting thing was that you went back to the corner and you're like, Danny, I'm not even sitting out of second gear here.
Nah, I'm sweet. I mean, I think it was in reverse. Stuff in reverse. Reverse the first, I had to go, Foxy.
No, but the thing is, it's like, I don't think people know your mindset, unless they know who you are and talk to you off camera instead of seeing you on camera. For me to try and describe your mindset, it's like, I don't give a fuck. Like, it's not like you don't give a fuck, it's like, I don't care. This is what I'm doing. You want me to do that? I'll do it. You want me to do this? I'll do it. You know what I mean? You always say to me it's not hard. But how do you keep that mentality up?
I don't know, because, like, it's mad. I just can't understand why anyone would give a fuck. It's madness. Like, it's just, to me, it's like, people go, like, I was out all day, like, farting about, out, and people going, you're fighting it. And I was going on, and we're like, not bad chilling out. I was in the bookies doing a football bet for the 3 o'clock scores. We're like, not chilling out, you know. I was like,
did your Cooper come in?
No, I didn't. I got stuffed. Fucking Liverpool 1-4-0. I had both teams to score. Fucking scumbags.
That's the title right there.
Oh, fucking nightmare. Fucking Liverpool beating the bet, just cunts. Mo Salah!
Yes! I just want to go back to that fight. You're talking about Godoy, man. This is the biggest fight of your career. Like, this MTK pushing you, and I've been to every single one of your fights from August last year up until, not August last year, August 2018, all the way through 19, now we're in 2020. What I've seen, the progression, the speed that you're moving at, and now let's talk about you moving down to lightweight. I mean, how close are you to one of these major titles? Whether it be an international title, I mean.
I'm beating harder opponents for no title. Realistically, I've seen people fighting for WBO.
Thank you
very much. Good luck. Thank you. Safe home champions. Thank you very much. Okay. This is exactly what I said.
You speak Spanish?
I French shit. Hey, man. I know it's just I'm fighting harder opponents for no title. I mean, he fought Vargas and got a draw. Mm-hmm. He fought Amir Khan. Like, Vargas has only lost 5 times against 5 world champions. Mm-hmm. That's the level I'm fighting at. And no title on the line. Still selling out the Ulster Hall, 1,200 people. That's a small venue, but I mean, it's the atmosphere's phenomenal. And surely I'm close now to the title. But again, you're going to see this, I don't give a fuck, Alex, because it's the truth. I don't give a fuck, because my attitude is not what I have now or what title I have now. It's where I finish in my career with world titles. See, if I go from now with no titles for the next year till a world title, give me it. Because all the other titles on the way up don't mean football to me. Because I aspire to
be
world champion.
Would that
world
be done
champion.
At 135, 140?
135, 140, 140, give me 147. I'm big, I'm mad and tall. I'll bulk, I'll get the creatine in there.
The Twixies, the Mars bars.
Get the Mars bars in. Sassy suppers with skin pulled back.
I don't know what the hell to talk about, Joe. I mean, fucking, what's happening next for you then? I mean, obviously, Jamie's obviously said a few things to you.
Yeah, I'm sure we're going to sort of say them. Like he said in conference, there's two big shows in Belfast this year. Mm-hmm. He said it in the press conference the other day, coming this summer. Two massive platforms, fail is one of them.
Cheers,
Tommy. Bang, bang, Ruby, yeah! Hey!
Hi, guys!
See you later. Thank you.
Oh, surely on one of them shows, MTK, they've looked after me massively. I really couldn't thank them enough. The word got me up the night and they've put great belief in me, Jamie, everyone behind me, Danny, the whole lot of them, Sandra, they all know now. I'm a good guy, I'm a nice fella, I enjoy a bit of crack, I'm an everyday person, I'm a very, humble person, you know what I mean? It's not like...
I'm going to say mad, fucking crazy, you're sporadic, you're fucking, I can name all the things that you're not naming,
Well, sure, we'll keep you in this here, keep you in for an order.
Well, if you want to know what he's up to, he's going on holiday next week, so just follow his Instagram.
Instagram, just Sean McComb, straight up, Seanie Mac, Sean McComb, and we'll see me on holiday next week.
And trust me, for somebody that follows him, you don't want to miss his Instagram.
This is what happens on holiday. Get up at 7 o'clock every morning, do a 5-mile run, come back, cook an asparagus steak and eggs, come back, 400 press-ups, back out again, 3 pints, 2 Jager bombs, 4 whiskies, 3 fights, 3 pub fights, and pass out.
That's it. And that, by the way, I can vouch for that. That's 100%
going to happen. Possibly get arrested. So, if anyone knows me and wants to post me bail money, feel free.
Because they have done it in Australia. So.
I've done it in Australia. Been arrested a few places.
Exactly. We'll keep that as the past. We're thinking about the future now, Sean.
New year, new me.
New year, new me, exactly. Sean, love interviewing, my friend.
Yes.
Can't wait to see you back in the ring. I'll probably see you after your holiday when you come back to MTK Scotland again. Thanks for this, Fightful TV. And
you're the man. Bang, bang, every chip.
Ah!
Yeah.